This morning in the kitchen, we welcome Zooma. We have Armando and Chef Marcello here. And what brings them here? Well, Rhode Island Monthly does. That's because this month's issue is all about Italian eating. You guys have a great dish that is Italian on the menu for us today. Chef, what are we making?
So today we're going to make involtini di speck, which basically it's made with the homemade pasta and some shallots, fontina cheese, peanuts, mushroom. And we're going to fuse this dish. We're going to make with three different kind of pasta.
Okay, so what do you have here? They're all different colors, obviously.
Yeah, we got the red beets spaghetti. Mm-hmm. We got the regular one, which is made with egg, and also some spinach spaghetti.
Yeah, egg, spinach, and beets. It sounds like a great combination.
Yes.
Armando, you were saying, too, I mean, you have, we will be showing our viewers at home how to actually make the spaghetti in just a little bit, but it's so fresh. Everything about Zooma, very fresh ingredients.
Yes, we make everything from our bread all the way down to our desserts. All of our homemade pastas are obviously house-made. Anything from the spaghetti alla chitarra that you see here to our sacchettini with the mushrooms. We even have caramelle, which have lobster and mascarpone cheese inside.
Yum. So lots to offer.
Absolutely.
Beautiful. All right, we are going to get this dish started in just a little bit. Back to you.
It's going great here in the Rhode Show kitchen. When you're told that a guy named Marcello and Armando are going to make pasta, anything wrong can happen. Nothing can happen. No. They know their stuff. What do you guys want to do right now?
Nothing. We just try roll the pasta that we're making advantage. So we are making the guitarra, spaghetti guitarra.
Okay.
Which this is the final product.
And basically what it is, just so everyone at home, I don't know if they can see it very well. It has strings on it. Like, we could play this when we're done.
Oh, sure. Actually, we play
actually, that's
on
what we really? Do. On Saturday nights, usually we get in the middle of the dining room and just play the old guitar, the mandolin. And
I'm telling you, before we're done today, these two are going to be rocking out on here. So that's what you're going to do, and that's the easiest way to separate the pasta.
Yes.
Okay. Let's talk about the restaurant itself. Restaurant has, it's been around for a while. It's a name everybody knows.
Yes.
A name everybody knows. Great Italian food.
Absolutely.
Food from all over the place. Favorite things on the menu people keep coming back for?
Well, there's a couple of things that we've been doing new. The first one is we've just brought in a pizza chef from Naples. So, un pizzaiolo napoletano is what we like to call it. He's outstanding. He does all of our fresh breads.
Wow.
And he does the pizzas. And he even every once in a while throws in a Nutella pizza out on a plate for me. So, the menu is actually changing. We will have a brand new menu as of the mid-December.
Sure.
We'll have some new dishes, some warm dishes for the winter. We just brought in a fabulous cuvée machine that sells higher-end wines by the glass. Really a nice new show. So we've got some definitely some big changes.
But and all of the stuff that is made at the restaurant, I would assume that you make, it's the old-school way of making it. It's the fresh stuff. It's the traditional way of stuff. So when you sit down, it's like sitting in your family's home.
Yes, we just use some fresh ingredients. We try to use all the local ingredients. As Armando say, we made our own dessert, own pasta, make it from scratch. And we try to use all the fresh ingredients.
Right.
You can see here, it's all fresh and nothing frozen.
All good stuff. All right, enough of us talking about this. We want to get to putting this together. We want to get to eating this and showing you what it all looks like when it is put together. And then these guys are going to rock out in just a little bit on their mint. So back to you. We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen. Chef Marcello Florio joins us today from Zooma. We've got a great dish that we are making this morning. It smells good. We're ready to go.
Okay, so we start to put some butter, and
let that melt
a little bit. After we put shallots.
Yum.
Yeah. Let it caramelize a little bit. After you have this color, let's add some mushroom.
Okay.
Any mushrooms in particular, Chef?
Well, I love to use the bottom mushroom because they are kind of delicate and not too much flavor, but
just enough
to don't cover all the other ingredients.
Right.
Well, right now I'm gonna put just some salt. And the pepper we're gonna put at the end.
Okay. And if these two salt and peppers could not be more opposite, I don't know what to do. These did not come as a set.
Well,
we're just gonna let everyone
we
know.
We got the discount.
We sure. Like one over the other, apparently.
Okay, beautiful. At this point, as you see, the mushroom will start to cook to brown. Let's add a splash of white wine.
Now it smells good, right, Chef? Oh, add the wine in there.
Yeah. And after that, let's add some cream.
Is not that heavy too much. Cream?
Yes, heavy cream, heavy cream.
If you're going to do it.
Okay.
If you're
going to
do it, don't skip on us.
Sure. And meanwhile, let's put some Fontina cheese.
Yum.
You know, regularly imported. Oof. Okay, perfect. Well, now it's time to put the pasta.
Okay.
Okay, pasta in the water.
And remind everyone at home, though, that's actually three different flavors of pasta, correct?
Yes, correct. We use the spinach, the beets,
okay,
and the egg pasta.
Okay.
Okay.
And because it's so fresh, that will cook up quickly.
That doesn't take very long.
No, it doesn't take very long. Usually they take like two to three minutes, depending on what kind of pasta, kind of pasta, if it's thick or... Not thin. Okay, let's wait until this is a little bit reduced.
Okay.
Both things are cooking away. And you've been at Zooma for a while now, and something that Armando is bringing up, too, is that everyone is Italian there, everyone who's in charge. You got a big Italian presence.
Yeah, because actually me, Armando, and the pizza chef, we are from Italy. Mm-hmm. We start to make, we don't talk, we yell.
Right.
So we yell, we make a joke.
I was going to say, there must be a lot of yelling. Is it like working with your family? Is it like being with family?
God, you cannot believe it.
Yeah.
Sometimes we fight, but in a good way. And we have fun. Actually, also the people that sit in front of the kitchen, you know, they start to enjoy, to interact with us.
Yeah, it's the atmosphere.
Yeah,
that's part of the fun of it.
That's all the count.
And you guys have been featured in this month's issue of Rhode Island Monthly, which is all about Italian eating.
Yes.
So we can't strive enough. I mean, especially being on the hill, you're in a perfect place.
Yeah, thank you. So right now, I'm going to take the pasta out.
Okay.
Let's make sure that all the water goes.
Gets out of there first.
Gets out, yeah.
That looks great.
No TV magic for this one. It cooked right in front of you.
All of the colors in it just look beautiful.
Yeah.
Spinach is so bright.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Okay.
We're not going to go hungry today with you here.
Definitely not.
Okay.
Yum.
Perfect.
Looks good.
And that came together quickly. So even if you're busy and you run around, you got a family or something, and you want to make this at home.
This is the perfect dish when you are busy. You don't you don't have time to cook.
Right.
Yeah.
So just put a pan and 3 minutes,
and you're good to go.
We like that.
Okay. Now we plate in. We wrap it with the speck.
Okay.
Speck, it's a smoked prosciutto, come from Val d'Aosta, which is northern Italy.
Okay.
And it's a very, very flavorful and tasty.
I love it. Like, I could eat that just without even putting the pasta on. I could eat that. I love it that much.
I believe you. Now we put some pine nuts, I'm sorry.
Oh,
I'm
going to
say pine nuts.
I love pine nuts.
And to give you now a little bit nice presentation, we wrap it.
Oh my gosh.
That's a sandwich. Look at that. Want to dive into.
Come on. Now and, that is good.
This is the Italian touch. You know, just some parsley.
There
beautiful.
It goes.
Beautiful.
That is
good.
And you know what? Look at that. You can actually eat it by itself now, too. I got one on the ready. Look at that. If you want to try to make this at home, which you can, it's very quick. Get the recipe online at WPRI.com.